Waterways across the country have been invaded and ravaged by tiny, destructive creatures called quagga and zebra mussels. The size of a fingernail, these clam-like species latch onto boats, watercraft, and trailers. Boaters unknowingly transport them to lakes and reservoirs nationwide. Quagga and zebra mussels are a problem because they attach to solid surfaces in large numbers. They clog water intake pipes, jam submerged equipment, and create havoc for water enthusiasts. The mussels first arrived in North America in 1988. Transatlantic ships carried them from the Black and Caspian Seas of Eurasia to the Great Lakes. Within 7 years, the mussels spread through most of the major river systems in the eastern United States. In 2007, they were detected in the West, in Lakes Mead, Mojave, and Havasu. Quagga and zebra mussels reproduce so quickly that a handful of mussels can become billions of mussels in less than a year. Infested areas of the Great Lakes have more than 700,000 mussels per square meter. Invasive mussels are a burden on businesses and local economies. In the eastern U.S. alone, experts estimate that mussels cost the power and water industries $5 billion each year. Companies must pay to remove mussels from clogged filters, pipes, and water delivery systems. There's also an environmental toll. Mussels can harm fish populations by filtering nutrients from the water. In great numbers, they can shift the delicate balance of fish and food supply, causing drastic drops in fish populations. Mussels also affect boat owners. They can cover and coat boat bottoms, clog engines, cover props, propagate in bilges and live wells, and, worst of all, spread to other bodies of water. Working together, we can stop the spread of invasive mussels and keep them out of our waters.
Hello, I'm Walt Maldonado, Conservation Director for the Utah Bass Federation. And together we can stop the spread of invasive species such as quagga and zebra mussel. Our beautiful waterways that we recreate and fish on are under attack, and I'm going to give you some tips today on how to stop the spread of these invasive species by planning your next trip on this trip.
I transport New Zealand mud snails.
I'd like to introduce you to Natalie, who works for the Wildlife Division and is an AIS biologist. Natalie, can you give us some tips on how to prepare for our next trip while we're on this trip?
I sure can. Let's go over how to clean, drain, and dry your boat. Those are the three concepts that you really want to remember for the next time you're taking your boat out to the next lake. First off, we want to go around the boat and make sure that you clean all the aquatic vegetation off, any mud, any debris that may be stuck to the boat or the trailer itself. We want to make sure that all parts of this are off your boat. One little fragment transported from this lake to another lake can infest an entire lake and spread a whole population of these. Next thing, we want to go through and drain all the water out of the boat. If you have live wells, which it looks like your boat has, we want to go through and empty all those out. We want to put the motor down, empty all the water out of the motor, and let it run back in this lake. All of this area needs to be drained and free of water. Ski boats and most wakeboard boats have ballast tanks. So what we want to do is, if you do have a ballast system, you want to make sure that all of the water is completely drained out of there every time. That's an easy way to take water from one lake and put it into another lake. And then the last thing, the dry concept. So what we want to do is dry these boats. We want to have 7 days dry time in the summer, 18 days dry time in the fall and spring, and then 30 days in the winter, or 3 consecutive days of freezing. That will kill quagga and zebra mussels and most other AIS that are attached to your boat. All right, Walt, we're to the last and very important step, drying your boat. We want to make sure that the motor is lowered all the way. Let all the water that may be in there get dried out. Next step, we want to move to the bilge hatches. Open that hatch up, let it dry out, and also you want to pull that bilge plug again and let anything that may be in there get completely dry. Next step is your live wells. We want to open up those hatches, let them air dry. Do you have any life jackets on your boat?
Yes, we do.
All right, we want to set those out, make sure we get all the water drained and dried off those. And along with life jackets, we have a few other things we want to think about. Tow ropes, anchors, inflatable toys, anything that may have come in contact with the water. We want to get those completely dried out before they go into another lake. Boaters, this is the self-certification form that you need in the state of Utah. It has all the steps to self-decontaminating your boat before you get to the state park or another lake that you're going to. Here's the sign where you'll find these. They're located at all of our state parks and reservoirs. Below that, there'll be a brochure box that'll have the self-certification form inside them. You need to make sure that these get filled out, put on the dash of your truck or the towing vehicle. If you cannot find one of these forms, you can go online to the Utah Division of Wildlife website, print one out, get it completed, and put it in your dash, and then you can just be ready to go by the time you get to the state park.
All right, Natalie, it's not near as complicated as I thought. So why don't you run the self-decontamination process by me one more time?
Sure, it's three easy steps. All you have to do is clean, drain, and dry.
Okay. Now tomorrow, if I want to go fishing on a different body of water, what should I do?
You need to have a professional decontamination done, and you can call these numbers to find the best place to do it.
Okay. Okay, Natalie, what is all this contraption here?
This is our decontamination unit. This is a stationary one, it doesn't move. You drove up onto this big wash pad. And is what we do here is we take care of the decontamination process for you. We'll go ahead and hook, we call them earmuffs, hook them up to your lower unit. What we need you to do on this part though, is you're gonna have to turn your motor on for just a few seconds and let this water get sucked up, and then we'll have you turn it off. The other thing we'll do is we'll just take the decontamination unit and the wand, and we'll take it and just spray off the outside, spray your rails, we'll spray down anywhere that had water on it. We'll just spray it off for you. If you used live wells, we'll go in and use a low pressure setting and just rinse everything out for you. That's basically all there is to it.
So working together, we can keep our scenic waterways free of invasive species such as quagga and zebra mussel by planning our next trip on this trip.